That was fun. That was painless.
Painless.
Yeah, that was painless. Thank you.
That'll be our tagline. A painless time.
Seriously, come couch surfing. Painless.
Welcome to Couch Surfing, the show where exceptional guests look back at their big roles, their little roles, and everything in between. I'm here with Jennifer Esposito. Jennifer, let's see what's on. You ready?
Mm-mm.
You are.
No.
We're going to do this.
Okay.
Let's do it.
I'm scared.
Don't be scared.
Hi. I'm very scared. I'm so
scared.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
On the morning in question.
Who's that baby?
Oh, my goodness. I was putting myself through acting school, waiting tables, like the standard thing that you hear. I really was. And I studied for 3-4 years at Lee Strasberg, and we were doing very serious and doing theater.
Right.
And then this comedy came along, and it was just like, oh, I think I could do this. And they actually, the first time I went in, they said, she's not funny enough. And I was like, no, no, give me another chance, because I've been doing drama. Like my teacher used to say, like, not even comedy in the classroom. So I said, let me come back. And I watched Seinfeld over and over and over and over, and I watched Elaine and how she was giving lines and what she was doing and made it everything bigger.
Bigger.
So I went back and auditioned like Elaine from Seinfeld, and that's how I got that role.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that was crazy, but that was seriously one of the most fun jobs I ever had.
All right, let's do this.
Okay.
Hold my hand.
I'm scared. I really am.
Hello.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, tone deaf, baby.
Wait, that was not the name of your band,
no,
though.
No, that was not
no,
it.
It was not called
It was Late Term Abortion was the name of the band.
I mean,
you can see it right there. Okay,
the
this
names.
Is how method acting I was. That was a real bicycle chain around my neck.
Are you serious?
And after, I don't know, 12 times of doing it,
uh-huh.
I was literally, I couldn't move. I could not move. Maybe that's what's wrong with my neck these days.
No.
I'm gonna call Spike. You know, Michael Imperioli wrote this script.
A lot of people do not know that.
Michael Imperioli and a man named Victor Colicchio.
And how did Spike pitch it to you? Because he had you in mind from day one.
Well,
which is
Michael did. He's the one that brought me in. And my original audition was with Benicio del Toro to play the John Leguizamo role. So, I mean, the whole experience was amazing. It really was. Yeah.
Speaking of amazing.
We're going downhill.
No, we're not. No, this is good. Let's keep going.
I'm scared.
Come on. Up next.
Hi.
Look at Sam.
That's Sam Rockwell.
He's the best.
Okay, so
look at this cast.
I know. This was a remake of a 1958 Italian heist movie. And you mentioned the cast, so let's talk about it.
I mean,
Sam Rockwell. William H. Macy.
Yes.
George Clooney.
Louis Guzman.
Patricia Clarkson.
I mean,
Louis
it goes
Guzman.
On. It goes on. And then me. And it's the Russo brothers. Oh, that is, look at this tight skin.
You look exactly the same.
I do, don't I?
You do, actually.
No, I don't.
You absolutely
no,
do.
I got to get that hair color back.
No, Sam Rockwell's got to get that hair back.
Seriously. He was amazing. I knew Sam before, just from being in New York and being an actor. And I was actually the first one they hired for this, Joe and Anthony Russo, and then they said, oh, we're thinking of this guy, Sam Rockwell. I was like, yes, yes!
And you mentioned the Russo brothers.
Yeah.
Are you in touch with them?
I wish I was. Call me.
Okay.
I can put on a bodysuit and be an Avenger.
All right, up next.
Why do you keep everybody a certain distance?
Oh, you're picking
huh?
good ones. Look at Don Cheadle. He's so friggin' good. I can't
I
take it. He's so good.
And you two were good together.
Thank
I mean,
you.
There's real heat in this scene.
You can't not be present in a scene with Don Cheadle. If you aren't, if you're not, you're dead in the water. So you have to be, look at him. He's so good. First of all, the material.
Yes.
So my manager got this script for someone else.
Really?
A man, a guy. And I was nowhere on anyone's list. It's usually the case. And she called and she said, what about Jennifer for this role? And they said, yeah, let her come in. And I literally read the script seriously in like 25 minutes because I thought it was one of the best things I had ever read. And I...
So you knew it was special as soon as you read the words on the
page. I knew
so
much that when I walked in to meet Paul Haggis to audition, I said, this is going to win the Oscar. And he said, from your mouth to God's ears. I said, no, it's going to.
It went on to win the Oscar, but it was controversial.
It was controversial.
Some people thought it should have gone to Munich. Some people thought it should have gone to Brokeback Mountain.
Yeah. I remember sitting next to Brokeback Mountain at every award show. Mm-hmm. And I remember they'd look at us like, really? And, you know, I think it deserved it. I do. It was just a great experience.
All right.
Yeah. I'm glad you're not picking any of the awful experiences.
Welcome back to Couchsurfing. I'm still here with Jennifer Esposito. Jennifer, shall we continue?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Maybe if I donated
a
ball.
Oh,
this was great.
I couldn't keep a straight face with her ever.
Why is she's holding a basketball?
She's
and
ridiculous.
It's funny.
She's ridiculous. So she says to me, she was pregnant when we filmed the pilot. She was pregnant, and they had her in this outfit, and she had these little socks and these little boots that were literally cutting off her circulation. I said, did you ever see Wizard of Oz? And she said, yes. I said, you know when the witch, the house falls and the feet crawl
up?
That's what it looks like. Get them off. They're awful. And she was like hysterical and then said, I love you. And then, of course, went to wardrobe like, you got to change my shoes. And they're like, Jennifer, really? And then in the weekends, I would actually, because we lived close to each other, I'd go to her house and her and Ben, her husband, we would make these ridiculous movies. There was one, we both had these afros on, we had polyester suits, roller skates, rollerblading down Hollywood Boulevard. We were these gangsters. It was honest, ridiculous.
All right, I'm
next. Feeling good.
I've just been on my own for so long that...
Again, one of the best people I've worked with. We had so much fun. I think they needed to make us separate because that's how much fun we had. We would be cracking up and dancing like right before a take, and then we'd be like, so did you do it? It was like,
show you old New Kids moves?
He was dancing all the time.
Really?
I was there when he was
Is that a requirement for you? You're like, I only work with dances.
I only work with dances, baby. No, but you know what? You're on set so long, especially doing, a drama on TV like this. I mean, you're there long, long hours, and he was wonderful.
All right, let's keep moving.
Uh-oh.
Up next.
Can only go down.
Oh,
no, okay, you're picking good ones.
Noah was using you.
I watched the show religiously.
Away from us.
And my manager literally called the show and was like, Jennifer loves the show. If there's anything, ever call us. And they called and they said, it's only one scene.
Okay.
And it's to play Noah's sister. And I was like, I can't do it. That's Noah. I was so crazy about the show that really when I went in, I was like, I'm not your sister. This is so weird. So crazy.
So you totally fangirled
on set. Fangirl, like a lunatic. And there was one, I remember one when they invited me back, because they kept inviting me back, when I was in the middle of Noah and Helen. I was like, I'm standing in the middle of Noah Helen. It was like, and they're talking like about breakfast. And I'm like, no, you guys are Noah and Helen. It was such a trip because
Wait,
I loved the show.
Wait, you parlayed one scene into six episodes?
Yes, I did.
All right, girl.
Yes, I
Look
did.
At you.
I guess I'm fun to have around.
Uh-huh. What did you make of the show's ending?
I have to be honest. I petered out a little. I did. I petered out a little, and I hate to say it because I'm... will always be a fan of the writing. I petered out after a while. It went a direction that I just didn't love.
Up next.
I'm really scared. He's still living in the barracks, Ed?
You two have such a sweet chemistry.
He's very, very nice. I've been doing this a long time, and the director of this, Danny, I knew him as a club promoter.
As a club promoter.
Okay, then I started to see he's doing this movie, this movie,
like,
this movie.
This can't be the same day.
This me too. I was always friendly with him, but I didn't know him. I didn't know what his aspirations are. I didn't know. And I really give such credit to people that go for it. And when he told me that when he first said, listen, I have an idea for a script, he literally told me a story. He said, Jen, I put on my suit and, you know, Danny, he's not the suit wearing guy. Nope. He put on his suit and he went to LA and he met with all these big people. He said, they laughed me out of the room. And that movie went to, not only did he make it, it went to Sundance. He did it. He called me one day. Jennifer, you want to do a film with me? Like, literally, it's like, who's
you
this?
Sound exactly like him. Like,
Jennifer, we're going to film. We got this one. We got Jamie Lynn. We got this. We're going to do it. Upstate. Are you going to, you in? I need to know. I was like, can I read something? No, and honestly, I was like, I'm in.
Did he give you the elevator pitch over the phone?
He literally, like I just said, you in? I need to know in like 20 minutes. Honestly, kudos to anybody who has that determination to keep going. I would do 5 other of his films because he did it.
And you did it too.
Well.
We're done.
Oh!
Yes!
Yay! You didn't pull any of the bad ones. I'm so happy.
Jennifer, thank you so much for surfing by. You're awesome. Mobtown is in theaters and available on VOD now. Check it out. See you next week on Couch Surfing.
It's painless. Bye.